think when it comes to understanding where to back up the data, it depends on why you need it. So for me, with my work stuff, I back it up multiple locations. I want cloud, I want local, I want everything just in case, because I literally would crash and burn without it. But my photos, this is also where it depends. How much do you care about it? There are so many free repositories out there, but there's limits. Apple gives you 5 gigabytes. Do you know how many people think their iPhone is actually backing up to iCloud? And then they lose their iPhone or they go into the phone store. Think about this. We all go in and they say, do you want your data back on your iPhone? Log into your iCloud. And then you go to do it and there's no data because you had 5 gigs. We can't fit our data into such a small size container like that now. So you could pay 99 cents a month for 2 terabytes. And that's what people need to be doing. So you need to understand how much data is on your phone. If you have a 128 gigabyte iPhone, Apple's free storage is not good enough for you, but Google will give you 15 gigs for free. So maybe you take your photos and you put it in your 15 gigabytes. And then you choose, okay, I care about my contacts and I care about my email or these files, and you put that for free in Apple. So you have to understand the size restrictions, and you have, this sounds crazy, but you have to look at the red indicators you get on your phone or your devices saying you're out of storage space. You have to read your email and check your storage space. So if you're backing up to Dropbox, check and look and say, okay, I still have 15 gigabytes of space, I'm good. You'll get warnings. Most people ignore the warnings and then it's too late. So you really just have to be prepared and be aware. While things are free, it's often really cheap to pay for more if you need it. And you could pay for more for your whole family. So I have family plans on things and I have personal plans on things. So you could be the educated tech person that then takes care of your children, your significant others, your brother, your sister, and your parents. And you put everything in one safe repository that everyone can access. But also make sure people don't have too much access to your stuff that you don't want to be sharing. When it comes to educating people, you have to keep it simple. So we can't make it seem like it's a chore to back up. Anything that you can educate your children, your parents, your friends, your coworkers, that is automatic. So it's out of sight, out of mind, and they just have the comfort knowing there's enough storage space. They will get an alert if something runs out. So every night, connected to Wi-Fi in your home when you're not going to be bothered, you should be backing up your data. My Mac is set that every 30 days, if it hasn't been backed up, it reminds me, and there's that pesky pop-up saying, this hasn't been backed up, this hasn't been backed up. And it reminds me where I usually back up. So then you're constantly checking what you still have there. Now you also have to be careful. When you set up anything that's automatic, you wanna make sure that you control it. So you wanna educate people not to click on things. If you set up Google Cloud backups, and then there's an alert that, hey, your AWS drive, and you're like, what's AWS? You should not click on that. So you need to understand where your data is going and where it is not, because sometimes your credentials could be compromised and you'll get a message. Even think of something so simple. Yesterday, I got a text message saying, your FedEx package, click on this link. I don't get messages like that from FedEx, and that's usually how it is. So it'll be your Google Drive information is compromised, but then you look at it and the message isn't from Google or just seems weird. Don't click on those things. Or, this is a wild concept, pick up the phone and call Google and say, hi, this is my information, I got this email, and I guarantee they're going to say we didn't send that. So you can't click on things and then provide your information. And also, this is really big. Google, Apple, Dropbox, anytime it prompts you on your device, it's going to prompt you to re-enter your passcode. You are not prompted for your user account information. And a lot of people don't think about that. It should already know your user account and it will make you re-enter your passcode or answer security questions, which is fine. But rarely do you see that pop-up that says, I don't even know your username. And that's where the attacks really get started. And that becomes a very technical thing. And there's so many things out there, the Ouch newsletters, securing the human, that will really educate you on what you should not click on and how to just be a little bit more cautious. Educate yourself on how to help them, but make sure it's not scary, because I think a lot of people get really overwhelmed. My dad, I tried to teach him password managers and backups, but he still wants to keep things on a sticky note under his keyboard. And he tells me it's still our dog's name and a street we lived on. I'm like, Dad. He's like, well, then you'll know it. But it's all about educating and making it not too geeky, not too nerdy, and not too scary. It has to be approachable.